Thank you very much. Yes, I'm telling nothing more or nothing different than Jürgen did. So in my point of view, it is that I'm responsible as a speaker for Choice in E-commerce. We started an initiative in the beginning of 2013 where we did a workshop in Berlin and asking some SME sellers to explain what's going on the market. And they told me, especially the electronic sellers, and they told me, yes, we would like to sell more products, but we are not allowed to, because we are prohibited by the brands, by the manufacturers, that we are not allowed to sell it online via marketplaces, we are not allowed to sell it via our own online shop, we are not allowed to sell it via cross-border. And so I don't understand it. I'm not a merchant. And so we discussed it. And afterwards, it was clear that it's not only the electronic market. It was more or less every vertical. So it was also verticals like sports, business, fashion, pets, and so all verticals were affected by this. And so we ran the initiative, and we started a petition. And we asked Europe-wide SMEs, are they affected by this, and do we have to do something? And we were really lucky about more than 14,000 SMEs signed this petition, and we handed this petition to Olli Rehn at the end of 2013. So this was the beginning of Choice in E-commerce, so we're going on and asking the sellers how it's going on with this kind of online discrimination. And what we want to have, so we do not need really new kind of regulations or new laws or something like that. We only want to have the same playing level fields like the offline business, like we have it at the brick and mortar business. So if you are allowed to sell in a shopping center and if you are allowed to sell it in your shop, you also have to be allowed to sell it online via marketplaces, because there's no difference. Why we are doing this? Because the buyer wants to do, they want to buy online. So at the end of last year, 1 year after taking over the petition, we made a new survey, and you have it in your copies at your place. So we run the survey regarding selective distribution, and we asked them again 1 year later, after we, for example, we had one big win regarding Adidas. Adidas was one of the biggest brand doing this kind of online discrimination, and in Germany they had really a big kind of contract sending to the sellers, and the merchants were not allowed to sell on marketplaces and something like that. But in the mid of last year, Adidas have to cancel all these kind of discrimination, because there was a case at the German cartel office, and the German cartel office clearly said it's not allowed to discriminate the online channel. And Adidas said, okay, we get an agreement and we change it. So they are more or less the first one and the only one, because there's still a case running against Essex, there's still a case running against Nike. And I got emails from UK regarding Brooks, also sporting shoes and sneakers, De'Longhi and Fatboy and all the other brands. So there are a lot of brands. And in the survey, we asked the sellers, was there any change? And especially after this agreement between the German cartel office and Adidas, and 25% said, no, it's going worse than better after this. So the brands always say, yes, we heard about the German cartel office decision, yes, of course, but it was a decision against Adidas. I'm not Adidas. So, and then we also ask them, okay, what kind of restrictions do you get from the manufacturers? And yes, the most important one is about sales in online marketplaces, that there's a restriction. But also 28% said they are not allowed to sell in their own online shop. So the merchant who bought the items from the manufacturer, who are allowed to sell it in the brick and mortar business, they are not allowed to sell in their own online shop. I don't understand this. And if you know this kind of this kind of contracts are only between manufacturers and experts on selling this good, so expert merchants. So this is the kind where they have a direct contract. They are working with this manufacturer for 20 years. They have 2, 3, 5 brick and mortar business, and now, because to run this brick and mortar business, they also need this kind of online shops, but they are not to, not allowed to sell this brand on this online shop. So. Then, of course, we ask what consequences will this kind of discrimination have? And yes, more than the half said there will be no growth in the business for the for the SME. And this, of course, is very important. But 15% said because of discrimination or because of these restrictions, we have to fire some employees. And 4% said we have to stop doing business just because of manufacturing and brands restrict selling online. And at the end, I would like to say why sellers want to sell these goods online. It's not because they want to fight against the manufacturers or something like that. It's just because the consumer wants to buy it online. They like to buy it online. And that's the only way, the reason we buy a merchant investing in an online shop that costs really money. They have to invest in new skills and something like that. They're only doing this because they know that consumers want to buy them. And so what I would like to say is, please make it more clear, more transparent, that there is no difference between an offline business and an online business. We just want to have that we more or less the same, because nowadays I've got, last week I got a lot of paper from one merchant with all the contracts. And the newest kind of version is that the contract of how you have to build your online shop, it's much bigger than the only than the normal contract. So nowadays the manufacturers say you have to do the logo there, you have to do this kind of features and that and that and that. So they describing exactly what they have to do in the online shop. And then I ask them, do you have also this kind of contract before your brick and mortar business? No, there's just a sentence that we have to be in your brick and mortar business. That's it. But before the online shop, you have paper like this, what you all have to do. Thank you very much.